Hey everyone, in this video, I will give you a quick demo of Supabase automated self-host. So first, let's talk about the challenges you might face when self-hosting Supabase. Self-hosting Supabase with Docker is quite easy. Even if you know the basics of Docker, you can easily set up a self-hosted instance of Supabase. But the complexity kicks in when you need to add a reverse proxy or you need to add an authentication service to protect your Supabase dashboard. So this is where Supabase automated self-host comes into the picture. So what does this project bring to the table? All you need to do is run a simple bash script and Supabase will automatically be configured for you with Caddy as a reverse proxy and Authelia for two-factor authentication. And of course, if you don't want to use Authelia, you can simply continue with the basic username password authentication. Okay, so let's jump right into it then. So let me quickly open up the setup instructions first. Okay, so first of all, you need to download this setup script. And you can simply copy and paste this command into your terminal. Then you need to make it executable. And then you have to choose the command you want to use. If you want the basic username password authentication, then simply copy and paste this command into your terminal. And if you want the two-factor authentication with Authelia, then this command. Here I am connected to an AWS instance. And for setting up Supabase, your AWS instance should have at least 25 GB of storage. Okay, first of all, you need to enter your domain. So this is the domain you want to serve your Supabase dashboard on. I am using NoIP, if you are not familiar with it. NoIP basically gives you some free domain names. You can easily use them for testing purposes. So enter username. This will be your username used for authentication. And enter your password. So let's talk about this step. Do you want to send confirmation emails to register user? What this means is that if you enter yes here, then you will have to set up your own SMTP server for sending emails. And any user who signs up to your app will not be automatically confirmed. They will have to verify their email first. So for now, I'm going to enter no here. Enter your email. So this is the email you want to use for Authelia forgot password emails. Display name. So do you want to set up Redis with Authelia? I'm going to enter no here. And that's it. Everything is set up. All you need to do now is just run the services with Docker Compose up hyphen D. So let's do it now. And Docker Compose up hyphen D. Okay, so while these images are being pulled, let's open up the firewall. We need to allow traffic on ports 80 and 443. So here I'm going to search for security groups. And let's create a new security group. You can name it anything you want. I'm simply going to write Supabase here. And for description, demo for Supabase. Now we have to work on these inbound rules. First of all, we need to add an HTTP rule. Allow from anywhere. And HTTPS. HTTPS will be your 443 and HTTP port 80. Anywhere. And I'm also going to add an SSH rule. And I would highly recommend you do that too, so that you are not logged out of your instance. And then click on this create security group. And we are good to go. So let's go back. And so now we are back on this instances page. We need to assign that security group to this instance. So I'm going to go to this actions, security, change security groups. And from here, you have to select your security group you just created. Add security group and save. And we also need to add the IP address for this instance to our DNS service. So here, update hostnet. And that's it. That's all we had to do. So let's see if our services are up and running. Docker PS format table. Okay, so as you can see, every service is now healthy. And now we can go to our domain name. So my domain name is supabase.serve.http.com. Copy and paste. So you can see we are automatically redirected to our Authelia dashboard for logging in. So here you have to enter your username and password. Not now. And now you have to set up two-factor authentication. So click on this register device. So once we are on this page, we need to click on this one-time password add. Now, because we are not using any SMTP service for sending emails, we will receive this one-time code in a text file. So back to our terminal, and we can easily get this access code by running this command, sudo cat volumes authelia and notification.txt. Now, I want you to keep this in mind that I am in Docker directory. I am still in this Supabase automated self-host Docker directory. And to execute. So here you can see we have this access code. And this is actually the email which would have been sent if we had configured our SMTP service. And verify. So now you need to set up an authenticator. You can use any authenticator you like and scan. Save. So once you have scanned this QR code and saved it on your authenticator, you can simply click on next. And here you have to enter the code which is displayed on your authenticator. And that's it. So now click on this hamburger menu and close. So now you have to again enter your authentication password. This is because that previous password was for setting up this whole process. So now you have to enter the actual one-time password. And that's it. Everything is set up. Two-factor authentication is set up. Your dashboard is protected. So let's set up a table. And that's it. Everything is set up perfectly. So if Supabase automated self-host helps you in any way, please make sure to leave a star on the repository and like the video, comment, share it, and make sure to subscribe the channel because I am going to bring in some more videos about Supabase. So I will see you in the next one.